The Long Road by Wolfland. Skarmory's shriek echoed through the chamber as it appeared in midair with wings unfurled, and a quick scan of the battlefield revealed Phoebe's next Pokémon. The shadows at the edge of the chamber seemed to close in around her Banette as it floated just above the arena floor. The wispy ribbon at the back of its head slithered to the floor as it tilted its gaze skyward to take in its airborne opponent. "Okay, Banette," Phoebe breathed, a tiny waver in her voice as she exhaled. "Let's do this!" Steven watched as Phoebe rolled her shoulders and squared up to the battlefield, grin renewed across her face. It was almost as if she was trying to reassure not only her Pokémon, but herself. Burying the oddity in the back of his mind, he too focused on the next round of battle and seized the first move. Skarmory! Screech! His flying type didn't need to be told twice, and it wheeled to stare down Banette and unleashed its signature ear-piercing cry. The golden glint of Banette's zippered mouth turned downward in a scowl as it was forced to shield its ears from the defense-lowering technique. One eye cracked open, just in time to spot Skarmory's follow-up dive bomb, wings aglow with energy. Too slow to dodge, Banette took the full brunt of the steel wing across the midsection, but not before its mouth flickered upward in a smirk. As Skarmory drove its wings through the ghost type, a movement caught its eye. Banette had taken the attack right to its midsection, but not before raising a hand high over its head. Red eyes met yellow, and with a wink, Banette's hand came down in a vicious chop, striking Skarmory at the base of its neck. Instantly, a shock of numbness flooded Skarmory's wing. Now off balance, its attack faltered, sending it spiraling to the ground with a pained squawk. Banette settled lightly on its feet as Skarmory skidded by in a cloud of dust, but not without a wince and a large, jagged scrape across its stomach. Skarmory had done a good deal of damage, but it didn't escape unscathed either. In a mess of angry steel feathers, it scrabbled back to its feet, armor covered in dents and scrapes from its crash landing. One wing drooped at an odd angle, but instead of worrying about its injury, Skarmory's eyes darted around the battlefield, seemingly searching for something. "Skarmory, what's wrong?" Steven shouted, eyes on his partner's increasingly frantic efforts. It wasn't until the next moment Steven noticed Banette too was searching for something through the dust cloud, but Phoebe was the first to spot it. "There!" she shouted with a point. "Get it, Banette!" All eyes turned to find a single citrus berry resting at the far edge of the battlefield, recently dislodged from Skarmory's grasp by Banette's knockoff attack. Simultaneously, both Pokémon locked eyes on the fallen berry, and before Banette could move, Skarmory leapt into action. Its long legs gave it the clear speed advantage, but Phoebe had another trick up her sleeve. "Feint attack!" Steven watched as Banette hovered where it stood, before fading into nothingness. "Skarmory, look out!" Its trainer's shout snapped Skarmory from its single-minded pursuit of the lost berry, and it skidded to a halt just as Banette phased into existence right in front of its beak. With a hiss, Banette bared its claws in a threatening display, and Skarmory flinched back, bracing for the blow that never came. Instead, Banette phased back out and reappeared across the arena, hovering atop the liberated berry. With a dismayed cry, Skarmory watched as its opponent skewered the citrus berry with a claw, and in one swift motion, unzipped its mouth and slurped the berry down with its tongue. Phoebe's giggle echoed through the chamber as her Pokémon fixed Steven and Skarmory with a smug smile. But Steven was too busy watching his partner to notice. Calmly shaking the feeling back into its injured wing, Skarmory tipped its head to the side with a clack of its beak. From the way Skarmory only looked on in silence, Steven knew that things were about to get ugly, and fast. Beneath that calm exterior was a bubbling cauldron of rage that was mere inches away from boiling over. Skarmory! His tone was placating, if only to keep some level of control over his seething Pokémon as he continued. It may have regained health, but its defense is still lowered. Gain some speed with agility, and then finish it! The clatter of ruffling feathers answered him, and he allowed himself a small breath of relief. Skarmory hadn't totally snapped. Yet. With a swift push, the steel Pokémon went airborne and began to climb, gathering speed. Phoebe, though, was not willing to sit back and wait. Bennett! Don't let them set up! Shadow Ball it from the sky! Steven watched as a dark mass began to shape into a sphere between Bennett's palms. Soon, the sphere was nearly the size of the ghost's head, and without warning, it fired the attack skyward. Skarmory! Dodge! Still building speed, Skarmory's sharp gaze focused on the incoming projectile, and at the last minute, it barrel-rolled out of the way. Phoebe frowned at the miss, but urged her Pokémon to keep firing. Again! Rabbit fire! Nearly faster than Steven could follow, Bennett shaped and launched Shadow Ball after Shadow Ball, filling the arena with a minefield of ghostly energy. But Skarmory was nimble on its wings, and it cut a neat path through the barrage and emerged on the other side untouched. Ah, fine! Phoebe huffed in frustration. Use it, Bennett! Ceasing its non-stop attack, Bennett's zippered mouth glinted into a smile as it reached behind its back and slid a wicked-looking needle from out of thin air. Dumbfounded, Steven looked on as the ghost Pokémon wielded the needle in a sword-like manner, pointing the tip towards the onrushing Skarmory. How could Phoebe hope to take on the full-speed charge of Skarmory's attack with that flimsy thing? But just as Skarmory nosed into a dive, wings brimming with the signature glow of Steel Wing's light, Bennett did the last thing Steven ever expected. The point of the needle wheeled 180 degrees and plunged straight through Bennett's own chest. The ghost shrieked in pain as the needle drove itself out the back, point dripping with black ooze. What? Steven blanched at the sight of the impaled Pokémon, and his incredulous gaze swung to where Phoebe stood, unfazed by what her Pokémon had just done. Except, he wasn't left to stare for long, as a tormented cry sounded from overhead. Mid-flight, Skarmory had begun to jerk and twist side to side, screeching in pain from some invisible force. Wheeling back to face Phoebe, Steven paled further as he took in the distressed state of both combatants. What did you do? Phoebe shrugged nonchalantly. Laid a curse on your Pokémon with Bennett's life energy. By now, Bennett had begun to succumb to the self-inflicted wound, breathing heavily as a puddle of black liquid pooled around where it knelt, one hand braced against the ground. Steven gritted his teeth as his attention turned back to where Skarmory struggled to stay airborne. Skarmory! The sharp tone of his shout cut through the air, and he saw the yellow eyes of his flyer flick toward him, hazy with pain. Finish this fight! A fresh wave of pain hit Skarmory, and its eyes squeezed tight as it veered dangerously low. But it refused to succumb to the curse's effects, and with a defiant shriek, it righted its flight and squinted down at its incapacitated foe. Steel Wing's bright light formed around Skarmory's wings once again, and it nosedived right for the target. Bennett could do nothing but watch as Skarmory bore down and slammed into it full force. The dust settled quickly, and Skarmory stood tall over the unconscious ghost. Eye sharp, it raised its head in victory. But before it could cry out, the curse struck again, and Skarmory winced, retching until it ejected a sticky black clod from its throat out onto the arena floor. Hurriedly, Steven grabbed Skarmory's ball and returned the afflicted Pokémon before any more damage could be done. with a grimace and a mental note to pay special attention to Skarmory's health after the battle, Steven selected another Pokeball from his belt.